If you are publishing books on Amazon KDP without making the A+ content, you are literally leaving money on the table. The A+ content is the section of Amazon listing page that comes under the name from the publisher, and it greatly increases the conversion rate of your listing. Not many potential customers read the description, but instead almost everyone will scroll the page and will see the A+ content. In this video, let's see how to create a step-by-step A+ content using Canva for a sample book about chess openings that I previously created. So let's get started.
Alright, this is my Canva home. The first thing to do is actually to create a new design. And here it's very important to look for a website. Because if I'm going to select the website Canva template, I can resize the height, which is what we want. So what we're gonna do today is to recreate this A+ content here. And as you can see, it is made by 5 sections. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The first and the fifth are bigger and the others are smaller. So it's very important to be able to resize the height of each one dynamically.
Also, on Canva normally, if you create multiple pages within the same project, all the pages will have the same size. By selecting the website template instead, you can dynamically resize each page individually, and this makes creating your A+ content like 10 times more effective, because you can visualize them all together, have a preview of the sequence, and when you download the project, each page will be a different image ready to be uploaded. It's super convenient. The A+ content in general is a combination of 5 different modules that you can select among many options on the Amazon editor. For this tutorial, I selected 5 modules in an order that I've seen working pretty well for books, but you can of course change the modules or the order to adapt it to your unique situation and preferences.
Actually, if we want to maintain the correct proportions, the height here must be 845. There we go. So the second page will be 422. If you can't pick the right size, you can just zoom in, and if you do that, you are more precise. As I said, these numbers are not casual, but it's to maintain the same proportions of the image that we are going to upload on KDP. Then I can simply duplicate this thing here. And since the last will be bigger, I can duplicate the first one and move it down. Cool. It's a bit hard to see, but this is the main structure of our A+ content. One thing we can do, actually, which is very useful, is to create a comment and write here, for example, section 1, and what the element of the A+ content we will have to pick. So in this case, standard image header with text, and the second will be section 2 image text, section 2 image text overlay. Section 3 will be a bit different, will be like 4 or 3 images, and the fourth one is like the second one, so section 4 image text overlay. And section 5 will be like section 1, so standard image header with text. There we go. Cool, this is literally the backbone of our A+ content, as you can see. Now we just need to fill each section, and then when we will download the whole project, Canva will split each page as a different image, so we will have 5 different images to upload on KDP.
By the way, if you are afraid of forgetting the precise measures or the steps to create the template, you can also check my website that I always keep updated with my latest content. I leave the link in the description down below.
So we are going to use the same design elements to match the aesthetic and have a professional and appealing result. So let's start with the very first section. I already selected a background, which is this one. This background is made of 2 elements. If you can see from here, there are 2 layers, one like wood and one shadow. You can look for everything here, and also you can look for shadows pretty easily here, and you can add the shadow that you want. Another thing very important that I really like in the first section is a big book mockup like this one that I'm going to put in here. There we go, chess openings.
To create the book mockup, click the apps button, then you can scroll down to look for the mockups app, or you can look for mockup in the search bar. Click the mockups app, then if you want to make a book mockup, scroll down until you see print here. Click the see all button, select the book mockup without the background, and then drag the book cover over your mockup, and your mockup will be created for you.
Alright, let's continue. Now, what we actually need to do is to insert the text. I already have it, there we go. This is pretty much the same text we use for the cover. You can change the effects to increase the shadow if you want.
For this tutorial, I'm using a lot of copy-pasting, assuming a basic knowledge of the tool. But if you're starting now using Canva and you need to learn the basics like how to pick the text, change font, select and group multiple elements, and so on, I suggest you to watch the previous video where I create the actual book cover from scratch. I will put the link in the description down below.
Another thing that I like to do is to cast a small shadow like behind the main text to make it stand out a bit better. So I have, this is the shadow, I just copy it so it is in front. If I want to put it in the back, I need to go to position here, layers, and move the layer behind the text. So there we go. Then we can use the very same elements that I used on the cover. There we go. And then to fill this part here, we are going to reuse this element here that we use on the back cover, with a slightly different text, but basically the same element. There we go. Master the best openings using tournaments. So if you see, the color is similar and it does match the overall aesthetic pretty well. Let's move now to the second section. For these sections, we are going to change a bit the background, so to create a little bit of variation. So I already have the background here. This is a gradient. If you want to do a gradient, you need to click here, then add a new color, select gradient, choose the new colors. The two colors that I selected are the one that are here in the cover, the bright one and the dark one. Also, let's copy the text. There we go. This is the same kind of text. I decided to put this kind of underline here to match the style of the border. And another thing that we could do is to look for an element here like chess to add in this area. In this case, I added this element here. Cool. The final touch for this is to reuse this kind of design to personalize a bit more this section. There we go. Pretty nice and clean. And this section is pretty much complete. Let's move to the next one. Actually, one thing that I could do is to add another shadow below the book. Here. Yeah. To make it a bit more realistic. There we go. And perhaps change the transparency a bit. Yeah, now I think it's better overall. Cool, the next section will be these four or three images, depending on how many points you have. This section will feature three or four points that you will have to go more in detail with text. So these are basically the icons on top of the text. This may be a little bit tricky, but I'll show you how I do the icons. So first thing, actually the icon is made up of multiple elements. I have an inner element, I have an inner circle and an outer circle. But you could also just select here for a circle and choose one which is empty if you prefer. I make it this way usually with two circles, one inside and one outside, so I can have more freedom about how to style the border and how to style the element in general. Also, I created a different aesthetic. So if you can see, one element will be more white and one will be more colored to match the different chess pieces. Basically, it's a nice design choice. So there we go, and the last one. Cool. As I said before, remember to write some text in advance, because you will need to put some text below each point when you will make the actual A+ content on KDP. Now the next section will be very similar to the second one, so we will reuse the very same background, the very same elements, and just a different text. So we can actually copy this one here. I think for the A+ content is completely fine to reuse this kind of elements, because really the aesthetic needs to be pretty similar, and if we put too much stuff, then it's going to be confusing for the people while they are scrolling the Amazon page. And for the very last element, we will do something slightly similar to the first one. So let's copy the background just to start. I will put a cheesy text here as well, and an actual separator. Now, since in the back of the cover I used this element here, we can reuse it to add a little bit of variation to the A+ content and continuity with the book design. And here I would like to put a mockup, but a different one from this one. So you can create another mockup using the very same app you can find here. So there we go. Let's rotate it a bit. Chess opening. This is it. Our A+ content is basically finished with all the sections here. And here we have the name of the element that we are going to select on KDP. Now we can download the project, and it's very convenient because Canva is going to separate each section in a different image, so we will be able to upload them easily. To download the project, just go to File here, Download. Here you can select a few things, but I'm fine with the default one, and press Download. And we'll download the images for you.
Now it's time to upload the images on KDP, but before that, if you got value from this video, please click the like button and subscribe to my channel to see more KDP tutorials, tips and strategies.
Now it's time to upload on KDP. You can go on the marketing tab here, and if you scroll down below KDP Select Amazon Ads, you can see the A+ content section. You can choose your marketplace here, amazon.com in my case, and click Manage A+ content. And this is it. We can choose a name, in this case it will be Chess Openings. And now it's time to add the modules. We will add 5 modules, one for each section. And as you can see, you can select more than one module, and it can be pretty confusing, but we already know which one to pick because we wrote in the comments here. So standard image header with text will be the first one, this one. Okay, so this is our image. Now here I can insert keywords related to my image. This is just for the screen reader, by the way. I wouldn't try to game the system, insert SEO optimized keywords. I mean, you could, but it is really just for the screen readers. So master the best openings used in tournaments. Okay. And then the second is this one, text overlay. There we go. Simple and practical guide to learning chess openings. And then the third one is actually these standard 4 images and text. Here it's a bit tricky since we have one image instead of 4. We could split the image using any like graphic design software, or we could upload the image and then like decide here, working with the zoom. It's not going to be super precise, but it does work. There we go. And we can do the same. Okay. And here is the text to add. This is very important. Headline 1, headline 4. I'm just going to put a basic lorem ipsum just to show you how this will go. Then module number 4 is going to be the same as number 2. This one here. Here there is no need in our case to add any text, and simply this text won't show up, only the image will be shown. And the last module is like the first one, which was standard image with text. And there we go, we can drag and drop our image here as well. Become the next chess master. Cool, now our A+ content is ready. We can actually preview it. And this is the final result. Pretty nice, simple, eye-catching. And this really increases the perceived quality of your book considerably. You can save it and apply the ASINs. This is very important. You need to add like each ASIN individually. If you published the ebook version and the hardcover and the paperback version, you will need to add 3 different ASINs here. Otherwise, the A+ content will show only on one version. The next step is to click review and submit here, and then hopefully it will be approved soon and the A+ content will show on your page.
Before submitting, make sure to check the A+ content guidelines on the KDP website to avoid a rejection. In particular, you can't insert pricing or promotional details, customer reviews, time-sensitive information like writing on sale now, for example, and only a maximum of 4 publication quotes are allowed. Please make sure to only take inspiration from this video and from other A+ contents out there, and to always upload original designs or your KDP account will be terminated. With the A+ content, your book will surely have a boost in sales, but if you're not selling at all, watch this video here to learn why potentially your book is not selling and how to increase sales. I'll see you there.